This is a quick overview of my workflow for organizing my handwritten study notes and my hand-annotated PDFs and other documents on my favorite note-making platform, Obsidian. I mainly use a Supernote A5X, but if you're getting your handwritten notes off an iPad, Boox, or other device, or if you're scanning paper notes and want to organize those, you can skip ahead to the parts you're interested in using the timestamps in the description box. It also contains details on specific Obsidian plugins I use. Now for class notes, I make one note per day I have class, and make sure to tag those with a keyword per course. I leave the default file names because I'm lazy, and since it has the date already, which is what I really need. Anyway, I can easily see the keywords I used to tell me what course or courses this note is about. This is a lot of notes, so I group them into one folder per month, and then I group those months into terms for easy navigation on my Supernote. I also frequently make notes directly on PDFs of documents or presentations that I need to read. When it comes to longer documents, I really like using the digest function since it helps me compile just the quotes from the text that I need and my notes on them. Then I can just use that summarized document in Obsidian without exporting the whole book. For things I'm currently reading or have to read really soon, I usually favorite them so I can view them all with just a few taps. And since I tag both my notes and documents with a keyword per course, I use the global search to find notes and readings for one course with one search of my Supernote. When I'm ready to drop things into Obsidian, I just export my notes, documents, and digest PDF, and all of this goes into my export folder. Since I have Dropbox set up for that folder, hitting sync is all I need to do to transfer my initial notes from here to my laptop so I can bring them into my vault. So here is my main page for my studies in general. On the same day I have class, I just click on that day on the calendar and make a new daily note using my template. You'll notice by default, this has a status field with a tag that says to do. This is because every new daily note automatically goes into an inbox on my main page to remind me to fill in the different fields and drop in my notes later. When I change the status here to done, it leaves the inbox. Here's the Dataview query, feel free to pause. The note I excluded here is the name of the template. I have a similar table below for when I make pages on specific topics to remind me to flesh these notes out more later. Going back to the daily note, filling in the summary field forces me to really reflect on what we cover that day. I'll jot down cases we discussed, for instance, concepts we covered, and other details about that class day. And then I go to my synced Dropbox folder with my exported notes, etc., and drop them in the body of this note. For instance, here's an exported digest on a case we were reading. I can view it right in Obsidian and scroll through it here. Same goes, of course, for PDF exports of my handwritten notes. This setup makes it really easy for me to find my original notes in three different ways. I can look at the calendar to easily find them by date. I can look at each course page, which automatically compiles a list of notes tagged for that course, which I'll talk about later. And if I go to the page of a concept or topic, if I link to it in the summary of a day, I can easily get to that specific day using the backlinks. Now my approach to Obsidian in general is, if I'm at my computer, that means I can Google things. I think there's no point in trying to recreate Wikipedia on my laptop. Rather than taking quotes from different sources and just compiling them, my goal is to only keep the information useful to me in a form that worked best for me. So truthfully, my pages on topics may not make the most sense to anyone else, I just make them in the way that helps me best remember each concept, and I just refine these pages as I go. For each course I'm taking, I keep a main page like this. As I mentioned, I have a Dataview query that automatically pulls a list of daily notes tagged for this course. This also shows me, thanks to the summary field I filled up, the different concepts we discussed in the order we covered them. This is great for seeing the coverage if you've got an exam coming up. You know it's on these topics and you can just click through to the pages to study for this test. I also like to keep a sort of summary page for courses that could use them, for instance if I want a list of formulas for one course in one place. I can always link to the more detailed pages on each concept if I need to review them in more detail. You'll notice I leave breadcrumblings at the top of each note, usually to the course a note is related to and other related topics, so I can easily navigate between notes. I hope this look into my study vault was helpful. Stay tuned to the channel for more videos on knowledge management and note making.